So let's talk about the integrated learning system and how it can help you overcome the number one problem that English students face. Hey, my name is David, by the way, from exlenglish.com, and I'm super excited to have the opportunity to share this series of videos with you. In this first video, I want to talk about why you should use an integrated learning system, because there's no sense in me telling you how it works and all the steps if you don't see the importance and the value in it. Now, like I said, this is going to help you overcome one of the main problems I see English students face. Almost every week, students look me up asking me for help with their English skills, and almost all of them face this same difficulty. So let me share a recent story of a student I was talking to and how this works to help you understand this problem. About a week or so back, I gave a workshop on using the integrated learning system, and there was a gentleman who was an internet technician. He worked for one of the largest internet companies in this city. He said, "David, I can read huge technical manuals in my area and understand everything I read. I understand all the technical jargon, all the technical vocabulary, no problem. But when I try to speak with someone like you, or I watch a movie and listen, I don't understand what I hear, and it's extremely frustrating." And this is a problem that most English students have, and it's what I call unbalanced learning. Now, in just a minute, I'm going to share a funny picture with you to explain this. But first, let's talk about unbalanced learning. It's where students develop one or two skills and forget about the others. So like this gentleman, you can read, but you can't understand what you hear. Or even other students that I've met who can speak, but they can't write in English. So let's compare that to a person who goes to the gym and wants to work out to get large muscles. So they sign up at the gym, they start working out. What happens? Their muscles begin to grow and develop, and after a while, you can notice the difference in their body. But what happens if they only work out with one arm? Well, the arm that they use to work out with, the muscles will grow, develop, and they'll get strong. But what happens to the other arm, the arm that isn't used to lift weights? Nothing, right? That's exactly what you see in this picture. Kind of funny, huh? But it's not funny when you're an English student who's trying to develop your skills, but you don't see progress in a specific area. That's where the integrated learning system comes in as a solution. The goal of the integrated learning system is to help you develop all 8 skills necessary for fluency together. We have the primary skills and the sub-skills. The primary skills being listening, reading, speaking, writing, and the sub-skills being vocabulary, grammar, pronunciation, and expressions. Now, they're all important, but remember that language is primarily used for communication. You want to learn English so you can communicate with others. You want to understand what others say, and you want to be able to express yourself. Now, it's important to point out that one of the key skills that you need to develop is vocabulary. So it's important that you constantly learn new words and increase your vocabulary. Because if you don't have a good vocabulary, how can you express yourself if you don't know the words that you want to say? Or how can you understand what others say if you don't know the words that they're using? So all of these skills are important because language is primarily about communication. So once you begin developing all eight skills together, learning English becomes much easier. One skill builds on the other. So you read something, you learn the words, you take those words that you learn and you learn how to say them and pronounce them so that you can understand what you hear. And then you begin to take those words and you learn how to form sentences, join them together with a grammar structure, and you learn chunks of words so that you can express yourself better when you begin speaking and writing. And as you do this, as you see your skills developing, this will motivate you to learn even more. So the goal of language isn't simply to take a test or to study simply for the sake of learning so that someday you can start speaking. It's important that you begin speaking every day. You learn a little and practice it because you have to practice and use what you're learning to develop your skills, just like the weightlifter. Now, I like to use the example of riding a bicycle or playing a guitar. How do you learn how to do these things? You learn how to ride a bicycle by going out and riding a bicycle. You don't read a book to learn how to ride a bicycle, just like learning to play the guitar. You can read books about playing the guitar, but that doesn't mean you're going to be a good guitar player. To learn how to play the guitar, you have to pick up the guitar and begin practicing. It's the same thing with your English. You have to practice and use what you're learning. So if you do that and develop all your skills equally, you'll look like a bodybuilder who is well developed. Instead of that first guy we saw with one strong arm and one weak arm, you'll look like a professional bodybuilder. Quick illustration for you. Doesn't he look a lot healthier and more well-developed than the first guy we saw? Of course. And as an English student, this is what you want. You want to be able to develop your skills effectively so that you can begin to communicate in all areas of the language. No more frustration because you can read a book but you don't know how to speak, or you can speak but you don't know how to write a letter. All right? So that's why we want to help you learn how to use the integrated learning system to develop all eight skills equally. As you can see in this series of videos, we're going to be talking about the integrated learning system story, the tools that you need, the step-by-step guide to show you how to develop each of these eight key skills individually, how to evaluate your progress, recipes that you can develop for the integrated learning system, and what you need to do now to begin developing them. But for right now, if you have any questions or you feel there was something that I didn't explain clearly, please leave a comment below. Or even if you just have a story that you want to share with us about your English learning, or if you have a tip or resource that you think would be beneficial for other students who are watching this video, go ahead and leave a comment as well.